Hello there. I'll just poke one eye in. The concentration today will be on my hands and what we're doing here today. So I thought I would try something new and, you know, I paint all the time, or that is my thing. So today I just wanted to switch it up and try something new, and I'll keep me out of the picture because I have major bedhead, and well, you don't need to be seeing my face for me to be sculpting. So today what I'm going to do is I have DAS modeling clay that I've had for like maybe 7 years. My mom gave me this for Christmas, and I hadn't had DAS since I was way younger. So I've been wanting to do something with it. And then yesterday I posted this picture and it got so much attention and everybody loved it. And then so I was thinking I was going to paint it today, but instead I thought, why don't I sculpt it? Now, I'm not going to do it in total three dimension, but I am gonna kind of do it like a, what would you call it? Like a plaque, so kind of flat on the back, but with dimension on the front. So let's get our sculpting brains going here and let's see what I can do. So I may not answer questions and stuff because I'm just gonna keep doing what I do. So I will try to see what I can come up with. So today will be the sculpting part, and then I will do the painting part a little later on. All right, so this is Chapel's Cove, and yesterday was so gorgeous and sunny, and the snow was on the dogberries, and I was just taking pictures like a crazy woman. And this is what, this is one of my favorites. So let's see how I make out. I can't even remember how to use DAS, but I figure we can figure it out. Okay, let's get at it. Enough of my eyeball in the corner. All right, here we go. So there's my reference. If someone can let me know if you can hear the sound, that would be good. And if the picture is okay, that would be great. So either way, I'm gonna keep going. I need scissors to get this open. All right, time to crack this time capsule. Oh my God, DAS definitely brings me back to my youth. All right. Oh, I guess I should have had a bag for this in case I don't use it all. How do I get in at it? It's childproof. Oh, there we go. Oh, look, we're in. Cracking the time capsule. So yeah, like I said, this DAS is about 8 years old, so I hope it's still good. It still feels mushy, so I think we should be all right. All right, let's get in. Whew. All right, so we've got this open. So now what I thought was we could do, I didn't know actually how to start. I knew I needed a shape, which I could make myself, but then I thought maybe I'll just sort of make it with rounded corners and this could be my molded form. And then once I get it in there, and then I could peel it out pretty easy. I don't know. Let's hope it works. Even if it doesn't, who cares? This is experimental. All right. I was going to use this, but I think this one is our better option. All right. Let's throw that down there. Okay, let's see. Wow. Oh, I guess I should take off my rings so that they don't get gunked up with DAS. And I will put them somewhere very safe over here. And I think I'm also gonna moisturize so that, 'cause I remember this like sucking the juice out of my skin. All right. Let's moisturize and see what happens. All right. Hello, Heather. I see that you are watching. Good morning. I'll try not to sing too much. It's definitely not one of my greatest talents. All right, here we go. All right. Ta-da. Okay, so to figure out how much DAS I need to put in here. Oh, and today's soundtrack is brought to you by Justin Bieber. I know, it's a secret love that I have. And I'll also show you the tools I have. I have my palette knife to kind of get in there for big stuff. And I blew the dust off of these little tools, which are my sculpting set from my fine arts degree days. And we had to take sculpture, which I'm very glad of because I would not have taken it normally. So here we go. I got some different shapes so you can make some different edges. This one I'd say I will use quite often. And this chummy, look, it still has the Sir Wilfrid Grenfell College price tag on it. How much was it? $10? No, it was $16.85 for a piece of metal. Anyhow, so it's kind of nice to be able to use these again. I haven't used them since, say, 1992. So at least now I'm getting my money's worth. I mean, I did back then as well, I should say. All right. So I kind of looked at a video about how to get started with this. So I have to figure out how much I will need to fill this and make it not too thick so that it dries in a sensible amount of time. Let's see. Well, let's just cut off half of it. Technically speaking. Okay, let's open it up more. You and she likes everyone to admit that I was wrong. Caught up in my, didn't see what's going on, and now I know. All right, so we've got, here, I'll turn around this way. Yes. Let me move my picture over. So I kind of thought, along with my revelation in the middle of the night, was, okay, I gotta just mush this, so I'll talk while I mush. Holy shit. Ugh. Now they also said to add water, and because this is about, whatever, 7 years old, that might take a bit to get it going. Okay, so you gotta mush it good and get it at a nice consistency. And also at doing my fine arts degree at Grenfell in Cornerbrook, doing the sculpture class was mandatory. You kind of had to do everything. You had to do photography, sculpture, painting, drawing, printmaking. And you know, if it had been up to me, I probably would have only done drawing and painting. So it was kind of good that everything was mandatory. I didn't realize how much it was going to help me later in life. Whew. And it's a good workout. So, a bit more water. And I've been wanting to use DAS for quite some time. Like I said, ever since Mom gave it to me for Christmas. And may I say that my family has been forever awesome about encouraging me to do my artwork. It's been just amazing. So Mom gave me this thing of DAS. Here, let me move it over. Which I had when I was a kid. And I used to make all kinds of little miniature things. Holy shit. So let's get into it. Man, if you didn't have strong hands, this could be difficult. And I'm kind of feeling like a bit of a weakling doing it. And I do stuff with my hands all the time, and even it's hard for me. And until it gets smooth, oh, you can't be at it, because then you'll have cracks when it dries, which I remember. Oh, we're getting there though. And it's worth the work in the end, I hope. So I'll just recap in case you're just joining me, is I'm gonna use this Tupperware lid as my mold, and this will be my background, and I'm doing like a plaque sort of sculpture. So it'll have a flat back. Let's say it could hang on a wall or something. And I'm gonna do this picture that I posted yesterday, which is of snow-covered dogberries in Chapel's Cove. Chapel's Cove is one of my favorite places to walk. I would say I have photographed every inch of it because it is so beautiful. And if you ever want like a pleasant, pretty easy road walk, go to Chapel's Cove. You can park right off the CBS highway and walk all the way in, and it's like a fairy tale. Even in the winter, and the snow is always cleared off the roads, which makes it easy to walk. Yeah, and there's not much traffic, which is wonderful as well. So, Chapel's Cove, you got it. And beautiful trees, there's like three ponds on the way in with ducks and lots of cool wildlife. Ooh, okay, we're getting there. Let's see. So yesterday I posted this photo of the snow-covered dogberries. And people were asking me if I was going to paint it, and I was thinking I was going to paint it up until I walked down into my studio this morning. This is called Artistic License. And all of a sudden I was like, I think today is the day I use my DAS modeling clay, which is super fun. So I had to blow the dust off of all kinds of stuff today, like my sculpting tools from my fine arts days. And the DAS itself that I've had for, I think, 7 years. All right, we're getting there, folks. Ooh. Let's see. And as I remember from sculpture in my fine arts days was, if you have any cracks or dry parts in your clay, that you will feel it later. So when it dries, it will crack, and you will be perhaps unhappy with the cracks, unless it's part of the look. All right. Okay. Whew. Holy, this is quite the workout. Okay, I think we're getting there now. So the key is to make it malleable, and let's see, let me get all the wrinkles out of the back of it, then we'll stick it into my very professional Tupperware lid mold. Well, that's the fun thing about art, is you can use anything to be creative. Whatever you need to get it out of you, right? So, this is fun. The only thing about live video is, I'd say I take shortcuts because I don't want it to be boring. So, anyhow, you can cut back in and out and check back in, because no matter what, it's going to take a while, so I might as well just relax and enjoy the process. Okay. All right, let's stick it in here. Let me see. Any comments? My granddaughter just bought a pack of clay last night. Hey, Helen. Must be a 2018 thing. Hey, Minot. Good morning. This will make for an interesting bus commute to work. I bet it will. Good morning. All right, so let's jam it into this mold and see what we've got. Maybe I have too much clay, I don't even know. And you know, after you do one of these, then you'll know sort of what to do different next time, but here we go. And I have to have enough clay in here so that I can cut the house out of it and like clear off the background. So it's like I have to reverse engineer it. Okay, let's get it all squished in. All right, this seems to be going all right. What is this? Let's get rid of you. Okay, so I'm squishing the DAS modeling clay into here. My mom will be thrilled to know that I've used the clay that she gave me all these years ago. I think she'll be surprised that I hadn't used it yet, which I am as well. Alrighty. And I want it to be good and flat so that when I cut into it, I'm not having to deal with creases giving me a hassle. Trying to now remember who our sculpture prof was at Grenfell. I think Kent. Was it Kent? No, there was another guy. Who was it? No, it was Kent. Kent. Oh, I can't remember his last name. Haven't been there since 1994, so I guess you gotta cut me some slack, eh? Okay. I should put the other part of the DAS back in a bag. Do I have a bag here? Yeah. Here, I'm gonna get a bag. And then if I need to take some more out in a minute, then I can. But I know this stuff dries really fast. I can already feel it drying on my hands. Okay. So keep it airtight, I do remember. And I don't like wasting stuff, so. Okay. All right. I need a cloth. There we go. Well, let's get rid of any clutter here on my desk. Okay, so now, if you just joined, I have molded out half my DAS stuff into a Tupperware lid just to give it some shape. And I'm doing this picture in three dimension, which is not my normal method, but it's 2018. It's time to try some new things, hey? All right, so let's move my desk. Here's the picture. Let's make sure you guys can see everything. Okay. Oh, rolling pin. Yeah, rolling pin would have been a great idea. Anyhow. It ain't happening. I already got it in here and we are good to go. Whoops, I got tin foil. Okay, so now, it's like I have to, it's the reverse of painting because you have to cut out what you're, well, here, I'm gonna move this. Where's the best place for it? Oh, maybe here. All right. Maybe move it over here. Yeah. Okay. So, I think how I have to start, because it is, because it is a house in the background, I think I have to make the house first. So I'm gonna cut away the sky from the clay, and then the house will start to reveal itself. So I think this corner of the house will be the highest feature of the clay, and then I'm gonna cut it all the way back, and then this will be the most shallow part of the clay. Yeah, that's my theory. That's what I came up with in the middle of the night. And then I'll cut the windows back, and then in relief, it will make windows. I think I'm gonna put the dogberry blops on top, and I'm gonna stick them on so it'll be like super three-dimensional for these. Okay, wish me luck there, folks. How's everybody doing? Can everybody hear? Just sticking my eye in. A rolling pin. Hi, Sadie O'Brien. All right. Okay, let's do it. Thanks for joining, by the way. Hope this is enjoyable for you. And even if it isn't, it is for me. So I guess that's all that counts. Okay. All right. So like I said, I've got my sculpting tools, different nibs, so to speak, different blades. Okay. All right. How do I even start? Do I have to maybe I'll just sort of draw out the house as I see it. Okay. So let's put a little curve on it. All right. And then the back of the house drops down this way. And then I'm gonna drop it out that way, make it a little more dramatic. And then this will come. That'll be my highest part right there. It's definitely not like using a pencil, I tell you. And I loves me pencils. All right, how do I cut away? Let me see, let's get in there. All right, so like I said, the house is going to be three-dimensional. So I have to cut away, the background stuff. So I also have some, where are we? Oh yeah, over there. We also have a bit of forest in the background here, so I have to leave that in semi-relief. And this will be more shallow, so the sky will be the most shallow part. This will be the second most shallow, and then the house will come out of the clay like this. That's the plan, man. Okay, so how do I get this out? Let me cut this down more. I did think about doing this video in time-lapse because I don't want it to be boring for you. But yeah, what odds, right? I will put it up on YouTube after, and maybe I will time-lapse it. All right. Okay, cutting out the sky. I can already feel where the cracks are in my clay. I could have molded it out a bit more. So you can already see the roof starting to happen. All right. But you can see the house shape. Okay. And clay is forgiving anyways, because you can always stick shit back on, right? Stuff, sorry. Okay, let's chop it out. Do I chop it all out? Yeah. It's like reverse engineering. It's the opposite of painting. Although kind of like when you're painting and you want your white paper to be the white of your painting, you kind of have to think in reverse. And so today will be the sculpting, and then, so where's our bush? It is here. So I want to make sure I don't cut away all that. Here, let me make this tighter. Cut out more of this. I go through stages where I like different music for my studio. When I first moved back here, I couldn't stop playing Hey Rosetta, Into Your Lungs, like my favorite. And then all of a sudden, I was right some Into Pink. She got me going in the studio. And lately, it's been the Biebs. I know, don't judge, but really, it's get up and go music, and it kind of, it's fun and light. Well, there we go. House is starting to reveal itself. I don't know how long this takes to dry, but I figure next Tuesday or Wednesday, I will go back live and I will paint this sucker if it works out. And I'll use this leftover clay that I've now removed. I will use that for doing the dog berries. How's everybody doing? Can you still hear? Oh, I'm listening to the Biebs. Justin Bieber, Corinne. Oh, Ed Sheeran. Hey, Helen. Maybe I'll try him after. But so far, Justin Bieber. And I'm sure after doing a few of these DAS things, like how to build it up will become easier, I hope. But it's always fun to figure out how to do something anyways, even if it's painting. There's a method to the madness. Okay. All right. Da-da-da-da. Okay, let me stick all this down. And I don't want the sides of it to be too uniform and perfect, so I will kind of beat them up in a little bit. So I'm gonna add a bit of water to smooth it out. How now am I gonna get this to be three-dimensional? I think I'm gonna have to, how do I do this? Da-na-na-na. Maybe I could build it up that way? I don't know. Here, let's. Da-na-na-na. So far, let me show you. We have house coming out of the clay. It will be something like this eventually, of course, with a twist. So here it is, just to give you an idea of my method to my madness. Okay, let's put some water on this leftover clay. Oh, I have my squirt bottle, sure. That's easier. This I use for my acrylics. It's just water. Shameless marketing. Ooh. Okay, so I will squirt this because that's way easier. All right. Actually, I'm going to squirt this too. Which will probably make it easier to mold. Okay. Now I need this to be the highest point because that's the corner of the house. How do I do that? Man, it's harder than I thought. Well, why don't I start? I'm going to mold these bushes back here. So, tidy up my edges. And dug it out. Okay, making the bushes on the side here. So actually I need to take off some of this so that it's not at the same level as the side of the house because it's in the background. So, but it will be more dimensional than the sky in the background. So I hope that makes sense to you. Hopefully when it's done, it'll make sense. So I'm cutting away bushes on the side of the house. And it's wild, you know, you spend all this time on the bushes on the side of the house and it won't even be the focus, but it's essential to the piece. It gives it depth. Is this it? Here, this one's cool. It's got very pointy tip on this end for fine detail, and sort of a curved pokey thing on this end. And like I was saying earlier, it was kind of neat to do my fine arts degree from 1990 to 94 at Sir Wilfrid Grenfell College in Corner Brook, which is a division of Memorial University of Newfoundland. Some big name dropping there, hey? Okay, bushes. So it can be very indistinct in the background because it is in the background, which makes it less in focus. So it will touch the sky here. I also don't want it to be too even, because nothing in nature is even. So I'll just put some good dents in there so that it gives it some nice dimension. The other thing I forgot to do was set my timer so that I don't sit here too long. Every artist or anybody doing any kind of artwork. So I set it for 45, so I'm gonna do, we've already been here for I don't know how long. So I'll set it for 30, which makes me stand up and stretch at the end of it because I could look like Mr. Burns. Did I press start? Yeah. I could look like Mr. Burns from Bart Simpson, from The Simpsons, all hunched over if I don't take breaks. So, all right, so there's our bushes in the back. Now I'm also thinking that when I paint it, it will give me some, will give me some leeway to be able to create more dimension if my sculpting is not, you know, so hot. Okay, let's see. Just smoothing out the sky here. But I don't want to make it too smooth because I want to have a bit of texture, you know? Alright. So our house is starting to pop out, and we now have a bush by the side. So now somehow I'm gonna figure out how to make this house look three-dimensional, with the highest point being the corner of the house right here. And then this will drop back and this will drop back. So it'll get lower and this will get lower. So wish me luck. Maybe if I, is this all right here? I'm gonna just mush this up. These will be my dogberries that I will stick on after. I'm gonna make them and then, oh yeah, this is way more. I needed to add more water to this when I started, but who knew? I haven't used DAS since I was 8, so, you know, I guess I can cut myself some slack. Oh, and it's a gorgeous day in my studio too. I'm looking out at the pond here in Holyrood and it is sunny. And the snow is perfect white, so it's a very inspiring scene for today. And I think that was part of what got me down in my studio. Hello, Gail. How are you? Reminds me of dental tools, only bigger. Yeah, that's right, for really big teeth. Hello, Jean. All right. So, like I said, this is the clay we've cut away from this. Oh, sorry. Let's put it in there. Alrighty. So I'll lay that there. And so I've added water to it so that it won't dry out on me. All right. So now I need to build this up. Oh, shit. How do I do that? Yeah, I wish I had added more water in the beginning to this mixture, because I think it would be easier to mold. Anyhow, I didn't, so let's do this. It's actually kind of cool to use my hands like this. I haven't done that for a while, so yeah, it's nice. All right, so let's build up this corner and get some dimension to this gorgeous old house in Chapel's Cove. And like I said, if you ever want like a good walk, like winter or summer, I will highly recommend it, especially in the winter, because the roads are always clear. There's hardly any traffic. And you get good flats all along, like three ponds. And then you reach the Atlantic Ocean, and there's a gorgeous beach there, and you can hang out on the beach. And so as you walk in from the CBS highway, yeah, it's starting to happen. I kind of got a wrinkly middle, but I think I can, what would I use? Maybe this. Let's see. And this is the more dramatic side. This side goes right down this way. So I need to make that a little more extreme than this side, which is the main face. Yeah, so in Chapel's Cove, if you, like I said, if you park right off the CBS highway, right by that cool sign for Chapel's Cove that's hand-painted by somebody, I feel like it might have been done for like a come-home year or something. Anyhow, if you park right there on the highway and then just walk into Chapel's Cove, it's probably a good... Now, I walk pretty fast, and it would take me maybe an hour and a half when I take pictures, of course. So the first part of it is super flat. And then once you get to the ocean, if you keep going past there, then there's like wicked hills, and I kind of do like cross-country ski skating, but without skis, up the hill, and which is a really wicked workout. So even if you have like injuries or you are physically challenged, I would recommend Chapel's Cove. Oh yeah, or just want a good hefty walk without much traffic. You can get lost in your thoughts and just watch the ducks, and it's wonderful. Okay, I'm starting to get a bit of shape. Yeah. So I'm now seeing that to spend the time molding out your original desk base would be good. I'm now feeling all the little wrinkles in it that if it was just smooth, I would have an easier time. But can't know that. Actually, I did know it, but sometimes I'm lazy or impatient. Yeah, more like impatient, I think. And really, I just need the shape because I'm then going to put the dogberries over the top of it. So it's going to cover up a lot of this anyways, but I do like, I like dimension. Okay. And we're only alluding to three dimension because it's only sort of pretend three dimension because it's got a flat back, you know what I'm saying? And I'm also now going to cut into this and get some dimension in the going into the sculpting. So here, I'll show you where we are. So I've got this, which is eventually going to be this. Ta-da. Can you see it? Whoops. Man, it's hard to do it in reverse. Oh, there we go. Okay. Coming along. Okay. So now what I'm going to do, I think I'm going to do some shape of the eaves and maybe a little dimension here, and then in the siding as well. So I think I'm gonna like this part because it's like drawing, but drawing into the clay. All right, let's get at it. What am I gonna use? I seem to be liking this what looks like a crazy ass dental tool. Gene, you wouldn't have the patience. Well, one thing I do have, which is, I don't even know where it came from, but I have a ton of patience. Now, for some things, I don't. But for artwork and detail, I have had it since the day I was born. My parents always said they couldn't believe how much patience I had. I used to make little vignettes of... How do I do this? I think I have to put material on it for the eave. Do I? It's kind of neat to try to... How do I do this? It's like you gotta really use your brain. And I can either dig in and this will come out, or I can add on a piece. Do I add on a piece? No, I'm gonna cut it out. Okay, so let's see, where am I? Here. And here. Actually, I don't want it to go that way. That'll throw off the perspective. Alright, so how do I do this? Draw this way. Can you see the sunshine coming in through the window? How do I do that? Drawing some guidelines. I'll show you. See a house starting to pop out? Woohoo! Alright, so let's cut. What do I do? Cut out this. Right now we are making eavesdrop. Actually, I'm gonna. Where's my chopper? It's easier to have a straight edge. Then once you cut it away, this is nice and straight. Is that how I do it? I don't know. We'll see now, won't we, folks? Oops. Oh yeah, and I'm also gonna cut away this a little more. This is a very good scooper. Actually, maybe, I don't know. It's tricky. Well, it's kind of neat to make dimension. Now, this has to meet it. Oh, that is tricky. Kind of looking a little crappy, but it is trial and error, and like I said, the painting will bring it all back up, and I know I can do some cool stuff with the paint. It is one of my skills I have for sure. Can you guys see good enough that way? Should I turn? Should I turn it so that, I don't know. I think this is the easiest way though, so that I don't knock the camera or anything. So this is under the eaves trough here. We'll have some dog berries. Now, I'm thinking adding the dogberries after is the right move. Who knows? It's kind of neat, though. You keep getting more dimension. Oh, I like this sculpting tool. So the more I work it, the more I am seeing how this is going. Okay. Oh yeah, I really like this. As Jean would say, this crazy dental tool. All right. And you can tell when something's right and when it's dimensionally wrong. And then figuring out how to fix it is. Is the creative part. Alright. Alright. And I don't want to be too finicky about it, but I am particular. Thank God for water. All right, so let's cut away. How do I cut away here? Nope, not that one. We'll use this one. This seems to be my favorite so far. It's a sculpting blade, I guess. Like I said, I got these in my fine arts degree days at Sir Wilfrid Grenfell College in Cornerbrook from 1990 to 1994. I'm not sure if this is right. I don't know if I should be cutting this away or just... I think I'm not cutting away anymore. Yeah. I think I just need to sculpt into it. Because no matter what, this plane of the house has to meet the eave, which is popping out. I don't know. Does that make sense? And maybe this is where I'm trying to decide if the painting is going to do what I need it to do. Okay. And I think I have a lot of leeway with the painting because shadows really kick it up. So this is the roof line here. And I don't want it to be too perfect. And like I said, the painting will allow me to put in like old texture. And coming along here, this is the roof. The shingles are above that. All right. So we've got roof starting to come out, and we've got bushes to the side. Now we need a little dimension in our house. So here, I'll just show you. This is the reference I'm using, which is a house in Chapel's Cove. Ah. Yeah, Jean, this is my first time doing this. Well, I should say I used DAS when I was 8. And I am not 8 anymore. So it's been a couple of years. I'll just put some definition. This is where the roof meets the house. And like I said, the painting will help when it's dry. So I've got like a window here. Window, which goes right up to the roof. And meanwhile, some dogberries will be over it. So in order to give the windowsill dimension, I'm gonna sink this back. And then it'll, the windowsill will pop out. Let's hope. And then under here, am I gonna give it another squirt of water? But you also don't want it to be too wet because it goes to like mud. Okay, and we also have another window down, whoops, down here in the bottom corner. So let's get that sucker in there. How far up? This far up? It's got a good angle on it, which makes perspective. Actually, the bottom window is sunk into the house. Is it? Yeah. So I'm going to sink that window in. So in the top window, I pulled the house clay back to make it pop out. But this one, now I'm going to make this one lower to sink it in. Flatten it a bit here. All right, I must say it's kind of fun to be getting my hands dirty using DAS. And like I said earlier, so now, hold on, I'm gonna cut in the windowsill. What else is there? This way. It's a double windowsill, so. In this way. It's one of those old windows that are inset into the house. So now that neat thing is we also have to think about, so you can see right here that there's curtains in the window, but I'm not gonna cut them into the relief because this will be the painting. I'm gonna paint in the curtains because in actual fact there would be no actual texture here. So this will be flat, but then I'll do this with paint. So for right now, I'm just gonna make the frame. And then the painting will take care of the curtains later. So let me flatten this out. Bit of water. Oh yeah, I can see how you could become a master of this once you know how the clay works. That is not me yet, let me tell you. But I'm already learning as I go along some techniques. Okay, that one goes down. And a bit deeper. It's pretty cool to see the house coming out of the clay. It's kind of amazing. Now my hands are as dry as anything, so I don't know if I'd want to do this all the time because I think I would age. Hello, Corinne. Oh, looking awesome. Thanks. It's getting there. It's very cool, I must say. And you know, when you start out, you're like, oh, I don't know if this is even going to work. And even if it doesn't, what odds? Anyways, it's just for fun. But the hardest thing when I became an artist for a profession was remembering how to keep it fun. I definitely had to balance that out in my mind because obviously my art used to be a hobby, just sort of something I did. But then when you do it for a profession, it can get a little tricky in the mind because you need to make a living at it. But you also need to stay true to your art and not try to figure out what other people want. But at the same time, you want stuff to sell. So I have a wonderful business coach and friend, Jennifer Trask, and she has helped me over the years find my passion for art while still making a living at it. And my husband, Besh, who is one of my biggest fans, and he has been fantastic. Ah, fantastic, get it? Okay. All right, we have dimension. So you can see there. Okay, let me show you what I did. Here we go. So now I've got a window which looks like it's sunk in, which it would be, and this window now that's the moldings are on top of the siding, so I built that one up, or actually I should say I brought the house down so that this window stood out. All right. Another thing I've had to learn is how to breathe when I paint. I seem to hold my breath a little bit, which breathing is always essential. And like with my paintings, once the structure is made, like, you know, the balance and where the lines are and all that stuff, my favorite part is really doing the details, which is now. So now we've got two little windowsill. It's a cute little window. Window, double-sided. Now there's going to be a whack of branches over this, which I'm not sure how I'm going to do that. I haven't really worked it out that far. This could be tricky. Okay, so we've got windowsill here. Now my clay is a bit wetter than I would want, but okay, let's pull this out a bit. So this will give dimension to this cute little window up there. Let's see. I have to lower my seat though because I definitely have the hunch on. Oh, oh my God. So it's always good when you're doing something sedentary like this is, except for my arm and my fingers, is to pay attention to the ergonomics of your workspace because it can cause you back and neck problems. I realized the first 2 years of painting full-time, I kind of developed a bad neck, and it's been with me ever since, and it's because I leaned forward on my chair towards my easel. Look! I got a window! Simple pleasures, hey? And I'm sure exaggerating the depth might be handy, because when it comes to painting it, maybe it'll give it more oomph. Which is why this being my first one, and I added too much water. So here, I'm gonna give this more dimension. Now, like I said, there's gonna be a big dogberry over this with snow on it, so it's amazing what you spend time on and then just cover it up. And this as well, I will be painting the curtains on the inside. Oh, there we go. I got a window, man. And with every little part that develops, it's like you can see the rest of it better. when I first started, it's like I didn't know where I was going or what I was doing. And I kind of like that the clay gives it like a choppy look, because I think that will add to the oldness of it when I paint it. I wish I didn't have this bump here, but who gives a shit, right? It's all part of it. Okay, now let me show you. I got a window. See the window? Now we've got two windows. And for anybody who just joined, I'll show you what I'm doing. So there's this, which I'm doing from this, which is a photo I took yesterday from Chapel's Cove. And I just couldn't take enough photos of the dogberries, and I knew I had to paint it because those red pops of color in amongst the white snow, like fresh white snow, is like, oh my God, the most delicious thing for me. Like, I just stare at them. After a while, Besh is like, Pye, you can't talk about the dogberries anymore. I'm like, but look at them. So anyhow, this is gonna be something similar to it. So we now have house, which is fun. So let's get back at it. And like I said, I'm gonna paint this after. I mean, after it dries, which who knows, this could take like 100 years to dry. But it's DAS, so here, let me just show you. DAS, I used half the clay for it, and I got the other half in a bag now. So I can use it for something else. And this is the clay I've cut away, which reminds me, I should mush it up. And this is gonna be the dogberries on top of it. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do about the branches of the tree though. I'll figure it out. Cause I think to make like little strands of this might look goofy, but I'm not sure I'll have any other options. So bear with me. Okay, so now what we're gonna do, I'm gonna put in the corner of the house here. Can you see it, the corner? So now I'm gonna give that some definition. And like I said, I'm gonna put on these dogberry blobs after I finish the house, so it'll look like they're actually in the foreground. And I may even exaggerate them and make them a bit bigger. So we have that window already. We have this window. We've got our, what is that, our eve? Yeah, our overhang from our roof. So now I'm gonna do some siding and some trim, and that will give it some definition. And then we'll start plopping these gorgeous puppies on. Okay, let's do it. All right, how do I do this? All right. Actually, I'm gonna use this one, I like this. And it's kind of fun to put my spin on it. Blah. It's kind of neat with each detail. I can see it emerging, which is super fun. Because when you first start, you're just like, oh, I don't even know if this is going to work. I don't even know what I'm doing. But I find this is like painting, but painting in three dimension. And I've been wanting to use my DAS for a long time. I know I said this already, but if you weren't here in the beginning, my mom gave me DAS for Christmas probably about 6 years ago. Thank you, DAS, for making your packaging so great that it lasted all these years perfectly. And I was also saying that my family has always been very encouraging of my art. My mom, my dad, I'm sure, and my sisters. Actually, and all my cousins. Did you know I have 47 first cousins? Yeah, 47. And funny enough, that's like probably a typical Newfoundland family. All right, so we have corner molding. And back to my parents being supportive of my artwork. I'm sure when I told them in 1990 that I wanted to do a fine arts degree, I'm sure they were like, oh, sweet Jesus in the garden. But they are such awesome parents. My dad has passed away, but so wonderful. And I think my dad would have been an artist if, now how do I get that to kind of come up in the middle? Oh yeah, I'm gonna put a bit of an angle. Oh, sculpture, you are so neat. I'm used to thinking in painting terms, but sculpture is a different way. Yeah, so when I said I wanted to do a fine arts degree because I really didn't know what I wanted to do, I'm sure they must have had some discussions about me doing a fine arts degree, even though I've always been super creative. I've been making shit my whole life. All right, so this is kind of giving it dimension. Now I can see the corner happening. And the roughness of the sculpture I think is really cool, because when I go to paint this, it's going to have more old dimension to it. And the paint is kind of rough. And I kind of have this dip here, but I think that's going to give it, you know, that old crooked house look. And I try to have a little less detail going up towards the top. So here, let me show you. Maybe not so obvious there. Try to show you. So we're getting dimension. Corinne, a friend told me there's supposed to be a crow somewhere in each of your paintings. Is that true? I have the clothesline one, and I'm always searching for that elusive crow. Corinne, I don't put crows intentionally in my artwork, and maybe it's not me. Maybe it's another artist, but I like that you keep looking and that you have Blowing in the Wind. That's a cool painting. I actually did Blowing in the Wind, the one you have, when I lived in Ontario. And it was one of the few Newfoundland paintings that I did when I lived away, because I was afraid that doing Newfoundland paintings when I lived in Ontario would make me too homesick. Huh. So that was one that I did while I lived away. I made my clay too mushy, so the lines aren't defined like I'd want them to be. Anyhow. Okay. All right. This is pretty cool. And I don't know if you guys can see it as much, but now it's starting to look like a house. Oh yeah, and when I did do fine arts back in the day, it was very challenging, I must say. Because all I wanted to do was draw in realism, but my profs were like, you have to do something else. So I fought them greatly. But in the end, you know what? I learned so much. And them teaching me to loosen up helped greatly, even though compared to most artists, I'm sure I'm not very loose, but. All right. Let's try this out. Can you see some dimension happening now? And if you just join me, I'll just show you what I'm referencing. Dogberries in the snow. So I'm making it out of DAS. So now I'm just building up the house, and then I'm gonna pop the dogberries on top once I make them, and then I'm gonna stick them on. So here we go. It's kind of funny to see it colorless. So what I'll do now, I'm gonna put on the siding marks. And this is one of those old houses that were probably updated in the 60s or 70s. So they have the thick siding, you know, whereas original clapboard is the thinner. So this is sort of 70s thicker, which is kind of cool. So let's do it. And now the angle of the siding is what also gives my paintings their quirkiness and dimension. So I don't exactly follow the proper lines. And if you do your lines too far apart for siding, it can look like romper room. So there's a fineness to it that needs to happen. But I don't like to do it like dead on because it gets boring. But it also has to follow some perspective lines because in the end, I like my, well, paintings or drawings to make sense visually, even though I manipulate the lines because I like it to have curve and a little dancing, if you know what I'm saying. And then as you get towards the bottom, it'll be a bit thicker. The siding will be. Alrighty. Okay. There's that way. Now I'm gonna put in, so I'm not gonna put in much up here because visually, so let me just show you. So see how you can see a lot of the siding lines in the foreground, and you'll see them on the side of the house here, but up here they kind of fade away, which gives it a perspective of how it's really happening. Corinne, did you ever use an overhead projector for your paintings? No, I'm a freehand drawer. I know it would cut down on like a million hours of work, but no, I don't. I'm old school. And drawing is like my favorite part. And so the lines in the siding determine your perspective. Oops. Now I don't like the way these lines are going. No. Look at that. That's easier than fixing a painting. Try that again. And I can tell when my lines are working, and then sometimes I can tell when I'm off track and it's not having the look that I like. So it's kind of fun to just be able to smudge it over. Do I teach drawing? No, I don't. I actually don't teach classes. At all. Teaching is not what I love to do. Okay, let's try these lines again. I like doing these videos. Okay, there we go. Let's get this party started. And the lines on the side here have to match up with your lines on the front, because that's how siding goes on. So even though I twist the perspective slightly, I like it to make sense ultimately. if that makes any sense at all. Yeah, there we go. It's giving it more perspective, like it's going towards the back of the house. Up we go. Up we go. And as of there, it fades away. So I'll stop doing it there. All right, now I'm gonna use this part of my very odd, what looks like a dental tool. So this one has a pointy top and this one has this curved flat. So I use the back of it a lot to level out my clay. And here, I'll show you. So I have in these very rough lines for siding, but as we know, siding is dimensional. And so the top piece is over the bottom piece, which is over the bottom piece. So now I am going to make that happen with those lines, because right now it's just like that, which is not siding. This is siding. Hope that's a good description. So what I have to do is I have to make each piece of siding. Oh my God, look, just like that. Looks like siding. And like I said, this is an old house, so the clay is really cool for the roughness, which I think when I go to paint it will be a benefit. Yeah, wow, look. Man, doing siding is friggin' awesome in clay. Instant gratification. So putting the bottom piece of siding underneath the top piece. And when this gets painted, I'm gonna put shadows under those lines. Holy shit, this is fun. Okay, fun. So, adding dimension to siding. Who knew it could be so fun? And thanks for hanging out with me, everybody. I really appreciate it. You know, I can be in my studio all by myself, which is kind of fun too, but it's also nice to have you guys here. So thanks for hanging out. I hope it's interesting enough for you. Yeah. It's kind of neat watching this structure come out of clay. A new experience for me. So if you are just joining me, this is my first time using DAS modeling clay since I was maybe 8. And I definitely didn't know what I was doing when I was 8. And well, I definitely don't know what I'm doing now, but I don't even care. I think it's gonna work out just fine. Holy shit, that's cool. It looks like siding. Okay. Now I'm gonna do the same thing here. So what I'm doing is making dimension to the siding. And so because this is the foreground, I'm gonna have more definition to the siding. And here on the side where it's going back is a little less defined, because as things go into the background, no matter if it's a photo, a painting, whatever, there is less definition. You'll notice in photos, you know, in the background, it's kind of blurry. Whoops. And so you don't want your side and background stuff to be as clear and crisp as your foreground stuff, and that's how you create perspective with any kind of medium. Now, I put too much water on this side of the house, clay. So it's kind of mushy, and it's not giving me the exact kind of texture that I would like, but trial and error. Here we go. All right. Here we go. That's pretty amazing the way that happens. I think doing the siding has been my favorite part yet. Wow. Wow, it really works. Okay, so I'm just gonna dull this down a bit because it's a little too crisp. And like I said, perspective wise, as it fades into the background, it will be less defined. So I'm just gonna diminish my lines a bit. Down, 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 down. And then when I paint it, I will also use color and shadows to diminish it as well. And as it gets up higher, it gets a little less defined. So let's just flatten these puppies out a bit. Here we go. Okay, it's still pretty amazing. I must say that it just pops out like that. All right, let me show you. Here we go. We have siding, people. Woo! Hi from Pennsylvania. That's wicked. Hello. We were just in Pennsylvania last July with Case Knives. And we loved it. Found it was a lot like Collingwood, Ontario. Anyhow, it was great. So here we go. We've got some siding. We've got some windows. And here, I'll just give you an update. This is what I am going for. And I've decided to do it in DAS clay, modeling clay. Here, let me show you. You know the one. So my mom gave me this 7 or 8 years ago. Still good to go because DAS puts it in like wicked dry proof packaging. So it's my first time ever using it, and I wouldn't call myself a sculptor, but I guess I'm painting in clay. How about that? Anyhow, so now we're gonna, I think the house is pretty much done for now anyway, so I'm gonna now put some dogberries on there. The only thing is I can't figure out how to do the branches yet. I'm not sure if I'm gonna have to roll them in clay like some of the major branches here. Maybe I'll make those. Oh yeah, maybe this here too. And maybe that will give it some real dimension, and then the rest of them maybe I will just paint on the house. And there's also shadows that will go in with the painting after it's dry. So let's make some dogberries with snow on them. This should be interesting. All right. Here, I'll leave it that way for you. Okay, actually, I need to turn it this way. Let me see what I'm doing. Okay. It's kind of neat though, after you... Now I can see the stuff that I did in the beginning when I was just figuring out what I'm doing, that I can now do better because I gained some skills in the last, I don't know what, hour? No, half an hour? I don't even know. I think I could put another line in here. Let's go with the... I can already feel parts of it drying. Like I said before too, I could have originally molded this clay more in my hands and added a bit more water. It was pretty dry, but inexperience and impatience got me at it. But next time I would definitely like molded in my hands for a lot longer. And also doing it via live video makes you, you know, want to keep it interesting. So I think I jumped the gun on molding out the clay originally. And I remember that from my sculpting days in fine arts. Let's try that. It's hard to get the perspective, like with an Eve coming out this way, like all this is Eve. I'm not even sure. I think maybe I could sink this in a bit more. There we go. I don't know. It's tricky, man. Maybe sink this down a bit. I don't know. I think hopefully the painting will take care of some of that. Hello, Jillian Power Marks. can you see that? Is it good? Hope it's all right. All right, we need to make dog berries. Here, let me just show you one more time. Now, time for dog berries. Bunk, 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 bunk. Okay, so now I need to make blobs of clay that big and make them flat on the back. And then I think I remember from back in the day, here, I'll mix as we go. So I have a piece of clay here. My hands are as dry as anything now. So let's, okay. Now we're making dogberry with snow blobs. Technically speaking. Hi, Lenore. All right. Okay, so now size of berries. Oh my God. Like it is very much a yeah, maybe. And I want them to be fairly dimensional. Like I want to exaggerate what's in the picture, but without it looking crazy. I don't know. Maybe I am crazy. Dogberry blob. And they can't stand out too much. Yeah, but maybe they can. Who cares? Okay, how do you make a dogberry blob? Okay, I think I'm gonna use my table so that it has a flat back to it. And then I'll, is that like a good size reference? Blob, blob. I think I can make it flatter because I also remember if it's too thick, the clay, it doesn't dry nearly as fast, but why am I looking for fast? So yeah, if you're interested, I would say this will be dry by next week and I will paint it, which I am really looking forward to that. Okay, dogberry blob number one. So I kind of got to do like a teardrop shape so that it's the snow on top, which would pile up on like a little teardrop sort of way. And now to make the berries underneath the snow. Boom, boom, boom. And it doesn't have to be so exact because, like I said, I'm going to paint it, so I have a lot of leeway with the paint. But you do need some texture so that it looks like it. And you have to make sure the snow is overlapping the berries. Okay, this is pretty fun, I must say. Okay, berries, 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 berries. Now we're working on twigs and berries. Okay. and have some good dimensions. So putting some deeper holes in it, I think, will make it just a little more interesting. Okay. Well, it didn't take long. And I'm trying not to get too picky about it, because once these are painted, they will look, obviously when they're red, you'll know they're dogberries. Okay, here we go. But some dimension is good. So now I'm going to show you, how do you pick up these suckers? And you don't want it to be too perfect of a shape, because dogberries are all sorts of clusters. Let's see. All right, here's our first. Now, how do I get this up? Oh, maybe this is what my palette knife is for. Like a spatula. All right. Oh, it's working. Okay, our first dogberry blob. It's pretty big. I do remember back in the day reading something about if you add something to your desk that you need to, score the back of it. So I'm gonna score the back of it. So I'm going to score I actually don't want it to cover my window. I can hear my hubby upstairs. He's going to come down going, "Pie!" And he won't know that I'm doing a video. So we'll score that, and we'll score this as well. Which makes it glue it on better, so that when it dries, it doesn't let go. Dogberry blob, number one. Boonk. Ah, it's big. Big dogberry blob. Okay, here we go. Okay, and stick. It's funny, you know, I feel like sometimes like art is very precious, and I wish I was a little looser about it. It's like now that I have the house done, I almost don't want to stick these on it, but you know what I'm gonna do? Hold on. That didn't work. Here, let me try this. Just to make sure it sticks. All right, and here I'll stick it on the sides a little bit. And so let's hope it sticks. It's kind of good to put these gaps, because there's gaps in the dogberries. And that's my hubby yelling. Where are you, Pie? They're too perfect underneath, so let me give it a little lift. All right. Dogberry blob, ready? One. Dogberries. So we are adding the dogberries with snow on them. Alrighty, let's keep making blobs. Okay, now I think I know what I'm doing. Oh yeah, so now a big one goes over here. So let's try that. How big? And this one's even bigger than the one we just did. So let's... Is that one bigger? I think for exaggeration, I'm gonna make it even bigger. Okay, so Dogberry Blob, here we go. Okay, so we're making this one now. Blob. Okay. So this one is at a different angle. It's an odd shape, which I like. If everything's too perfect, it don't look real. Uh-oh. Where's my sculpting tool? Okay, so the snow kind of goes at an angle for this one. Angle. And over that way. So we'll pull the bottom down, which gives the snow an overhang. Whoops, that's not the right tool. I hear my music has turned into Christmas music, and I realize I am done with Christmas music. So I'm gonna have to change that up very soon. Okay, so we have snow. It's not uneven enough. And now we're gonna make berries. Actually, I don't even know what to make one. A few. I want some of them to be round, but then I also want indistinct, just blobs of it underneath. Like I said, painting will bring all this up nicely. So some round dogberries.
Besh?
Yeah.
Hey.
What's up?
Doing a live video.
Okay.
He usually comes in the house whistling.
Hi. Thank you. Look what I'm making.
Whoa. Whoa. Wow.
Look at you.
Well, I know, right?
Didn't even know you could do that.
I didn't know I could do it either. I still don't know if I can. So, dogberry blobs. So, making them perfect without being too perfect. So we need some rounds to indicate berries, but then also just texture. And they can't be too perfect. And they have gaps and stuff, so I'm gonna make some gaps. These are pretty thick. I maybe could have made them thinner, but it'll give it an immense amount of dimension.
Upstairs.
Yeah, I heard. Thanks. Okay.
Saw Beth Kane at Costco.
Oh, yeah.
Sarah's 4 weeks out.
Oh, good. Baby on the way. Okay, and dogberry bottom. Now this is too perfect of a shape, so I'm gonna stab a big hole in it to shake it up. And move them back. We'll call this indistinct dogberries in the background. Like I said, nothing in nature is perfect, so you kinda gotta beat up your berries. A gap. All right. How do I get this up? And I can always go back into it again after it's on. So, Dogberry Blob number 2, which is this one up here. Can you see it? Ba-da! Okay. And now what I do, I'm going to turn it over and score the back of it to help it stick to the base. Which I don't think my first one is stuck very well, but oh well. Okay, so this one goes over this window. So all that eavesdrop that I worked on is now going to be covered by a blob. And part of the window. And part of the sky. So I'm going to squish this down. Okay, let's see how it goes. And on it sticks. Let's see. It's kind of got a tilt on it like that. I don't know how to stick it. Stab it. I think I have to press it, like I have to press this guy. And then I'll re-sculpt it again. Okay, everybody stick. Whew! I'm kind of nervous. Okay, let's get our snow back again. And it's, like I said, it's too perfect of a shape, so let's get it some unevenness off to the side. Bit of water. Let's squirt the whole thing. Without making it too wet. Dogberries. More gaps. Have you ever seen like a perfect cluster of dogberries? No. Always has like holes and unevenness, but even in the unevenness, there's perfection. They're so gorgeous. And I love that the dogberry color lasts into, well, January so far. So there's all this gorgeous white, and in the last few days, beautiful blue sky here in Newfoundland. And then these dogberries just being amazing. Makes for great pictures. There you go. Some dimension. Shake it up, people. Shake it up. So, as soon as I finish this, I'll give you another look. Let's pull down some of these. It's like it's all at the same level, which makes it look not real. Let's pull down the sides a bit, so it looks like it's fading off, and by doing that I can also stick it to the house better, so that when it dries it doesn't fall off. There we go, it's starting to look more like real dogberries. And stick and stick and stick. A little less. There we go. Here we go. Another dogberry blob. Here we go. I'll just give you another peek. So this is our reference, Chapel's Cove from yesterday. And right now, so I've made the house with the background. And now I'm making the blobs, and I'm trying to make them less perfect because dogberry blobs are not perfect. So let's get this one a little more dimension. And snow is not perfect either, but I tell you, it was looking pretty perfect yesterday and today. Here we go. There we go. Oh, everything's better when it looks less perfect. And that is what they taught me in fine arts at Sir Wilfrid Grenfell, which is Memorial University. And I did the four-year program there, and they taught me to make things rougher. I was pretty photorealism when I went in there, and drawing was like my only thing. So they helped me loosen up. I fought it greatly, though. I was not in the mood to be told what to do, but if I wanted to get the grades, I had to loosen up and tear some paper and glue shit on and rip it off. And so in the end, they were right, which, you know, kind of like my parents back in the day, I didn't really want to listen to them either, but turns out they may have been right. Okay, there we go. And if it's too round as well, it doesn't look right. So let's rough it up and pull it out. These blobs take a lot of work. How many more blobs do I have? Okay, so let's make our next one. Okay. My hands are drier than anything, which in your 40s, the last thing you want are your hands drying out to make them look any less young. So I'll be moisturizing like crazy now when I finish this. Okay, so now I think we will do some of these blobs. And these don't have to be as defined as the ones we've already put on. So now we'll make these, and we don't have to put as much work into them because they're not in the foreground like these are. These are our main ones. That one, probably that one, and that one. But these two are the main, so we've got those done. So let's now get these little blobs here on the go. Okay? And thanks for hanging out, by the way. Here, I'll just give you one more look. Just saw my cousin Tanya came on. Hi, Tanya. We're doing dogberry blobs. I could come up with a more technical term, but that's it. Okay. So let's do it. So our next shape will be, let's do this top one here, which is about that big. Okay, and this is DAS modeling clay, just so you know. And Mom gave this to me about, 7 years ago. Whoops. And it's only now that I've had the idea, the inspiration to use it. So, here we go. All right, dogberry blob. Okay, so this is a big puffy, I mean. It's got long elongated. And each dogberry branch, or what do you call those, cluster? I think that's a finer term to use than dogberry blob, is a different shape, which is cool. We don't want them all to be these perfect little round things. So where's my tool? This is what I'm using. This seems to be the main one. I like this for fine lines, and I like this one for less fine lines, but then flattening out areas around it with this. All right, let's go. How is our clay? Okay, good. All right, so snow is up high here. Dun, 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 dun. So the snow is on top of the dogberries, so I sink in this part so it looks like the snow is overhanging. There we go, we have overhanging snow. Now let's put a big dent in here because it looks like there's a lot missing from that part. Here, I'm even gonna cut off this part. because I think it's too much clay now that I've chunked out part of it. And I'm going to chunk out a bit here. Okay. Yeah. Let's do it. Bit of round. So you want some indication of round dogberries, but not the whole thing. So it looks like, you know, a strand of grapes or anything. But some rounds. Where'd my sun go? Oh, it's like a snowstorm outside. That's Newfoundland. You can go from gorgeous sunshine to snowstorm in a heartbeat. Okay, I'm gonna cut out more because I want some good gaps in it. My other two shapes are pretty perfect, so I don't want them all to be that predictable. And I would like to change my music because it's gotten very sappy and goofy. Beshman? I'll get him to change my music. Could you change my music?
Sure.
Can you turn it to like one of those new jobby channels?
Coming up.
Justin Bieber has gotten a little light for me. Oh, Besh said weather's coming, or it's here, I think.
It's hitting tonight, but some cats think it's just going to come and drop and then...
And be done,
but I have...
Okay.
Friday's going to be a good snow day.
Tomorrow's a snow day?
Thursday night into Friday.
Oh no!
Yeah,
we'll wait the kids for a sleepover. Okay, there we go. Kind of looks like a jellyfish, but here's our next... dogberry blob. Can you tell? Here, I'll show you this one. So we're making the blobs. Here's this guy. This one right here. Okay, let's stick them on. So we flip them over. Score the back of it. Oops. So that it sticks. Thank you. Let's rough it up. And then we look at the spot where it's going to land, which is here. Yeah. And it's kind of cool where I'm putting it on the background, which is lower than the house. It's going to look dimensional, like this little blob is further back. So let's do it. Let's look at his angle and plop. Actually, I want him to be up above the edge because that'll give it some cool dimension. All right, on you go, buddy. So let's just glue him on a bit. And there we go. Give them a little security there. And a bit of glue, not real glue, just sticking glue. And then I'll show ya. Let's dig a hole in him. He's too perfect. After I flip them over in my hand to score them, I find it like puts everything kind of too tight. Yeah, a bit more space in here. Ta-da. Ta-da. Okay. Indistinct dogberries. Kind of distinct, maybe. A little hole, little dimension, and stick. Sorry if my head's in the way. So sorry. Know your angles, people. Know your angles. Oops. Okay, stick them on. Okay, now let me show you. Here's another dogberry blob. Ta-da. See where we're going with this? It's actually starting to come together. When I first started this, I was like, I don't even know if this is going to work. So, dogberries on top, and I still don't know how I'm going to do the branches. So, we'll figure that out after. Until then, I think I have to turn on the light, though, because it is getting dark because snow has descended on us. All right. What do I need? So now let's do these little ones down below. And I'm going to try to make these less distinct because they don't have to be. Okay, so now we're going to do like these little dogberries. Okay, flat back. Okay, snow. Kind of a teardrop shape because the snow piles on top. Oh my god, they're so pretty. Alright, and where's my tool? And we do snow on top. Snow up the side. Squish down the stuff underneath. Makes it look like the snow is overhanging. And then we'll just put a few dents. Make it a little, make it more of a bell shape here. And dent it in that way. All right, I think that's, oh shit, oops. And my little spatula. Dogberry shape. Now we flip it over and we score it so that it sticks to our base a little better. And it's funny, I actually remember this from when I was 8. Otherwise I would not know it. So now this dogberry goes right over the trim here, but I'm gonna move them to the side because I like my trim. Score it. And so all the clay that you kick up here works as a gluing factor. Okay. I'm gonna put it slightly up onto the corner of the house. And stick. Okay, and let's stick them on. Stick, stick, stick. Because you also don't want your pieces falling off after it dries, right? Okay, that's good shape. He just needs a big hole right there. Okay. Try not to be too particular, which is sometimes difficult for me because I love the detail. There we go. A few little dents to indicate texture. And when I paint this next week, probably maybe Tuesday or Wednesday, the paint will create definition. Okay, let's see. Glue it on the back. Okay. Here's another piece. Which is gonna be something like this. So we're just making dogberry with snow on them pieces and sticking them on. How's everything? Is it too dry? I think I'm gonna give it one squirt. So there we go, and one more. Okay, let's make a few more pieces. do, I think we'll do some little ones. And the size of the blobs indicate dimension and perspective. So the bigger ones will look like they sit out front, and then if we do littler ones with less detail, they will blend into the background. That's the theory anyway, so let's see if it works. Okay, little dogberry blob. And I actually think I'm gonna sculpt this one right on the piece. So I won't do the detail here. Let's do it here. So let's stick this little sucker on. There we go. On you go, buddy. And then now let's make our snow. Actually, I should have probably done that with all of them, because then they stick better because you're pressing on it. So this one might stick the best. But I think they'll all stick. Gotta make them less perfect. Let's get some squishiness to them. There we go. And let's put a hole in it, because there's always dents and stuff in dogberry bundles. Okay, there we go. There's that guy. Big blob of snow. No, not till later. And let's make a few more little ones. Gerald, so what do you do? Let it just dry and paint, or do you fire it and paint it? This is DAS, so it just dries and then you paint it, which is great. I don't have to fire anything. All right, let's stick our little chummy on here. Actually, this one's gonna be pretty flat, and then I'm gonna stick another one on top of it. Actually, yeah, okay. I'm making this up as I go along. All right, I gotta score the bottom of it. Because there's also overlap, it'll look contrived. All right, here we go. Give them a different shape. And I make them a bit flatter. Stick them to the other one. And then snow. And then squish. Bit of texture to indicate berries. There we go. And imperfect snow as well. Okay, and glue it. There we go. We'll make a few more shapes. Here, I'll just show you where we're at. Here we go, house in Chapel's Cove. I'll just give you the reference. Now we're just making dogberries, and we're layering them up so that they look real-ish. Of course, it is sculpture, so now let's make a few little ones to stick in the background. Alright. Score the back of it. And this is my first time using DAS since I was 8. I guess I have to keep saying that over and over again for some reason that I don't know, but just so you know, I don't actually know what I'm doing, which you may be able to tell. Okay, and stick. There we go. This will be a background one. in order to create dimension, and then some snow. Like I said, next week I'll paint this, and shadows and all that will make a big difference. So let's just get this guy a bit of shape there. Stuck on. Let's make a few more little blobs. We'll put another little one next to him to show dimension. And we'll stick him there like he's on top of it. Get a bit of a cluster going. And snow. Okay, and then another bigger one to go on top. So now we're actually starting to get some dimension, which is making me happy because it was looking kind of flat there for a little bit. Is he too big? No, maybe not. I think he's good. And to exaggerate the size of the dogberries is also fun because it does give it more extreme sort of perspective and it'll make it a little more dynamic. There we go. Let's score the back of it. Rough it up so that it sticks to the main part, which is, where does this one go? Maybe, oh yeah, I'm gonna put them right here. Put them on top of this one, which will make it look more real. As there are layers of these little suckers. Let's stick them on. There we go. Oh. Now, guaranteed I should have taken a break before now, but it's kind of hard to stop when you're using clay. I mean, I can squirt it, but a bit of texture here, make one round berry. And let's stretch out his shape. He's looking too perfect. And let's dig a big hole here, up in here. Yeah, there we go. More holes. Alright, and what else do I need? Up here I need some little blobs. Now these are going to be smaller because they're further away in perspective. So let's do this. And I still don't know what I'm going to do for the branches. I don't know if I... Oh shit. I gotta score some more. That's it. Stick on. And snow. So these will be kind of indistinct because they are further away. Stick it on. Put a little hole in there. Alright, we got him. So there's another little one up there. So let's make him. Score. Right. Ready? Score the back of it. Score. I'm gonna lay him on top. For dimension. There we go. And like I said, when I paint this sometime next week, Wednesday or Thursday, there'll be more dimension. Let me just take a chunk out of them. There we go. And dog berries. Stick a hole in them. All right, let me show you where we are now. Who knew the dog berries would take so long? Anyhow. It's all important. You got to build it up and give it dimension. Bye, Jean. Thanks for hanging out for the morning. Ta-da! I'll show you how it turns out later. Okay, let's do more dogberry blobules. There we go. Ugh. I have to improve my posture here. Getting a little crickety. Okay, do the back of it so it sticks to our base. Let's put this here. Da-da-da-da, and stick. Oh, I want him to be out past our border. Give it a little more dimension. And just a bit of snow on this guy. And I'll scoop out a bit. There we go. Stick them on the bottom. So it'll be interesting to see how this dries. But from what I remember from very much back in the day, it's good stuff. Okay, I'll stick them on. Stick, stick. Okay, they almost look like jellyfish. All right, so now we're gonna do a few more little chummies down here. So let's just, where do I put them? One there. Let's put a little one here on top of him to give it some imperfectness. I'm not scoring them, which I'm sure I should, but this is where I get impatient, and I should not, but that's life. And the thing is, making the shape of them as well, like the size of them, I should say, is important because it shows them going into the background. And then make them littler and littler as they go away, which is like forced perspective. And we'll stick it there. Now just give them that snow and then stick them. Lots of snow on these. Speed them up a little. And this guy has a lot of snow. And thanks for hanging out, by the way. It's kind of fun to have people here with me. And make this less perfect, just like a perfect ball, which if I just make my shape a little less perfect before I stick it on, that would be handy. And stick you on too, and I'll sink them in a little bit, which will push them into the background. All right, we're getting close here. What else do we need? Got that. Just gonna put it one in here. It'll be smaller, which will make it look like it's in the background. Stick him in there. Strange shape. If I put him a little bit flatter as well, it will put it into the background a little more. And I'll make less distinct shapes so that it looks like it's in the background more. What else do I need? What else? I think we're gonna put like a little one underneath this big one. It's kind of fun now being at the detail part of it, which is my favorite part. Oops. Let's turn them this way. And let's stick them on. That's a lot of dogberries. Stick, stick. And just change up his shape a little bit. Let's change up. This guy's too round. So there we go. Just give him a little squish. Stick him on. Oh yeah, there we go. It's like the less perfect shape they are, the better they are. And I'm gonna put another little one. And I don't know if you can see it, but see where the corner of the house is? I've kind of left it open, but in leaving it open, it looks too fake. So now I'm gonna put one over the siding just to give it a little more like mesh, so the dogberry's meshing into the house. It's like you need it to connect without connecting too much. Holy shit, that's heavy, man. All right, I'm gonna put one here without covering up the corner of the house too much. And put it on top of this little one over here. A little bit of mush. Change up the shape. It's a bit round. There we go. What else can we do now? All right. I think we need another one over this way. I'm just gonna see a big one, maybe a bigger one. No, he's trailing off. I want him to be less. I'm gonna just make sure he's stuck good. Stick him on top of these two, which will give it that layering effect. Push him down, and he's got a lot of snow on him. And I'm also thinking when I go to paint this, that more snow against what will be blue sky will be pretty cool. I'm gonna mush these in a bit together too, because, whoops, sorry, am I right in front? Whoops. And I'll answer questions later, so if you want to ask anything at all, just put it in the comments there, and I will answer them later. Anything else? I think I'm going to put one more down here, because I like the big splatter of dogberries. Put another little down here. Like one there. And I'll put one on top of it for that dimensional look of which I speak. Okay, this is super fun. And it's something different than painting, even though I love painting. And I've wanted to use DAS now for, well, 8 years since my mom gave it to me for Christmas. Maybe I'll give this to her when I'm done. She has no wall space. Which means I've done my job. Okay. Let me show you now. More dogberries. Woo-hoo. Like I said, next week I will paint this. So now my only dilemma are the, let me show you, the branches. Do I now make like little rolls of branches and try to make them look good, or do I just paint them later? Kind of feel like maybe painting them might be cooler. I don't know. All right, let me see. Let me assess. I really don't know. Shit. Decisions. Artistic license. Let's see, if I paint them on. Let me just see if I can make a branch that would look sensible. So I will have to roll this out. Let's see. Oh, it's not rolling very well. Oh, yeah, it is. Oh, here. Oh, my God, my hands are full of the old clay. Okay, let's try that. Wet her hands. Oh shit, now it's too mushy. Maybe. Okay, making branches. Because sometimes I find if it's too thick, it won't have a fine look that I like. I don't like, I don't want it to be like Lego branches, if you know what I'm saying. I don't think I can make it thick enough or thin enough. Branches. No. Anyhow, I got it too wet. Let me try a drier piece now. Oh, here, let's mush all this together. Can I make, let's see, branches. No. I'm going to paint branches because I can already feel this is not giving me the resolution that I want. So I think we're going to paint branches. So that'll be next week at about maybe Tuesday afternoon or Wednesday. I will let you know on Tuesday if it'll be Tuesday or Wednesday, and then you can watch the painting of this, which I'm super excited about. So now I'm just gonna do a little more. Now that I got everything stuck on, I can see what's happening. Actually, I'm just gonna do one more. You can kind of see bare spaces once you've got your whole thing done. So let me just put a couple of like really small ones up here, which would indicate they are further away. Blob, where is it? Here. It's kind of neat because there's random, actually stick him under this guy. which makes it look like he's further away, and because he's smaller, it looks like he's further away. So this big one is clearly on top of this one. And what other little ones could I do? I'm gonna do one more on top of this bush. Stick them on. And I'm gonna move them outside our frame just to give it a little extra dimension. There we go. But not too far out. Now I'm just wondering if I should take them out of this Tupperware lid. I guess it'll dry faster if I do. I'm kind of afraid though. Let me just move this down. Now I can just pick out a little more, and it's kind of neat. It's the first time I've used this, as I've said before, since I was 8, and it is DAS modeling clay. And so when I started this morning, I had no idea, how to use it. So as I've gone along over the last few hours, I now have skills that I didn't have when I started. So it's like now to go back into it is kind of cool. And I'm also going to put just some little lines in the siding that give it that clapboard look. Let's put a couple over here. Just gives it a little depth. And then smooth it out. She also don't want it to be too obvious because it's just where the boards join. And meanwhile, I can also put this in with paint, but I'm just enjoying using my little pointy, what looks like a surgical tool. And maybe if I pop it out of this form, then I can make the edges a little rougher because I don't want them to be like this perfect rectangle. I'd like to beat up the edges a bit so it looks more sculptured. Trish O'Doherty, hi from Victoria, BC. Hello! We were just there a few months ago. I'm glad you joined us. Looking forward to our first trip to Newfoundland in July. That's awesome. Good time to come. It's our best month. That and August. Actually, September's gorgeous too. So enjoy. So do you think I should pop this out? Let me just pick at it a little more. Now I got all these dog berries in my way. Like I said, it's kind of cool. The clay is kind of giving it this old look as well, which is kind of fun, which will add to the texture of it when I paint it. Alrighty, I think that might be it. So let me show you what we did today, class. So from this picture from yesterday of our walk in Chapels Cove, Newfoundland, my dogberry love has translated into this, which is DAS. Whoops. DAS modeling clay. So now what I have to do is just let this dry. Oh yeah, and I used a Tupperware, so to speak, lid to make the base of it. And so I'm gonna let that dry, and then next week around, I guess, Tuesday or Wednesday, I will paint it and it will certainly come to life, and I'm gonna put in some good drastic shadows as I do in a lot of my paintings. So this is my first sculpture in what, 20? No, how long have I been out of my fine arts degree? 25 years? 1994 to 2017? 18, I don't even know what that is. So here, I think I'm gonna take it out. Can I get it out? Oh shit, I don't even know if I could get it out if I wanted to. Maybe? Do you think I should pop it out? Or just leave it to dry in it? It might take forever, hey? I don't know. Actually, I don't think I maybe would have to like put my hand on it and plop it out. Maybe I'll leave it. It's probably better I leave it. Okay, so anyhow, thank you very much for hanging out. Thanks for your comments. I'll read through them after I am done. And if you haven't already, like my Facebook page here, and I think you can turn on notifications or something. And so next time I go live to paint it, which I think I said will be next week, you'll be notified. And I also post a whole bunch of stuff. Here, let me poke my eye in. Like I said, I have bedhead. I just got out of bed and came downstairs inspired and started at this. So yeah, so I post all kinds of stuff, photos. I do paintings of Newfoundland. I'm in love with Newfoundland because I lived away for a long time. So to be back home again, which I have been for 8 years, I'm madly in love with it. So if you want to explore Newfoundland through my artist eyes, join along and feel free to comment and share my posts if you're feeling the love, and let's have a chat. So thank you very much for hanging out. Here's our Dogberry Winter Wonderland. And afterwards, this little sucker's also going to need a title. So once it's painted, if you're inspired by a title, I will give you the opportunity to let me know what you think. And yeah, so thank you for hanging out. Hope you have a wonderful day. And yeah, I think that's it. Now, let's try not to get my phone too dirty. Okay, thanks, folks. Bye. Much love to you all. See ya.